So I said, good morning, guys. Yesterday, we started with the syllabus of this product design and development subject. We were working on the first chapter, that's introduction, right? So yesterday we talked about what is product. First, we tried to understand what do we mean by product. Then we have seen some examples of what is design. What is product design? What is this process is all about? We took a couple of examples of like designing a scissor or chair. So anything, we can take example. It has to go through process of this designing. So after that, we have gone through, these procedures, like what is the procedure for, very high level procedure for design. Okay. So we talked about that yesterday. So let's today talk about what are the factors which affects the design of the product. Okay. Then we will talk about what are the new approaches, and then we'll take at least a couple of examples of the product design in that, how the concept is put and all that, like, what are different phases of the product design. We'll talk about that in this first unit. So, okay, let me just share with you guys the first unit. Let me just stop sharing this and let me share. Syllabus, so that we will see what we would like to cover. I would like to go share screen, and where is that? Okay, so this is syllabus of this first unit. So design of product design, we talked about it. Today we'll talk about essential factors of product design. Modern approaches to product design, we'll talk about that also. Standardization, simplification, and specialization. So these three things, what is standardization means, why it is important in product design, simplification, and specialization. Okay, so we'll talk about that also. Then product development and design, we talked about that little bit, what is development and what is design. So we'll talk about that in detail. And modern product development process and testing and validation. So this is also part of this modern approaches. So basically, we'll have these next five lectures will be, including today's will be, one lecture will be on essential factors, one lecture will be on the modern approaches, one lecture on standardization and simplification, and then we'll take one example of design, and then comparison of the product development and design. So we'll talk about that in these next five lectures, so that we are going as per the syllabus. Okay. I just wanted to make sure that we are going as per the syllabus. Also, now let's again go back. So today we will talk about what are the different factors which affect the product design. Okay. So we have in between increment of one guy. So as I said, guys, kindly your videos should be visible. Kindly make your videos on. So that whoever is joining, I wanted you guys to be with me. Ajay, you to the video on ahe, but tu disat nahi hai zyada. So bag me tu kuthe hai. Okay. So just make sure you tumcha video on ahe ani tumhi sagla jan mhanje attentive aha. Bas baki kai nahi. Ani kai questions vagere asel, whatever questions you have, kindly ask me in the chat, as I said. Okay. So I hope everything is audible and we can now continue the lecture. So today we'll talk about factors. Now, first of all, what is a successful product development? Okay, means product development or product design, how we can say it is a successful, it is a good one. Yeah, it is whatever you design is good one. In that we should have, as I said, there is important that golden triangle we talked about yesterday, right? We talked about in that triangle, it had three things: quality, cost, and time. Means you have to give a good design or good product of good quality. It should be of good cost. Good cost means the cost should be as minimum as possible, and your time should be as minimum as possible. So it should not take too much time. So I don't know whether you guys know, but today we use these touch screens and all that. But when it started. I think I was in US that time. This idea first came from Microsoft. Okay, I remember very clearly that they had something concept called Surface. Microsoft, they used to call it Surface in 2000. I'm talking about 2000. In 2000, they had an idea that something like a surface table will be there, on that glass will be there, and people can touch it and do selection of, like, you know, in a hotel, or selection of the menu and all that. So they had this concept in 2000, but they could not materialize, or they could not make a actual anything out of it. It was just a concept. I have seen those videos in those, and we were fascinated by that. But nothing happened after that. It took too much time for them to actually do something, or have some prototype or have some product on that. In between, by 2006, 6, 7, iPhone, iPod came, as I said, and then fantastic technology of touchscreen came with such a small device, and then Microsoft was left behind. So what I'm trying to say is that time is very essential. Like, you cannot have a product of awesome product after, too much of time, then it will be useless. People will not, somebody will go ahead of you. So you have to give a good quality product with the cost, time, and the other things are also important, like development cost, product. There are two costs, production cost and development cost. Now, what is difference between these two? To understand this clearly, we can take an example of this corona vaccine, right? So corona vaccine, we are getting in 250 rupees. Like, say, it is, I don't know what is the price of that currently, but it will be to around 200 to 400, right? So it is very, our cost is not that high. So what is difference between product cost and development cost? In this case, the cost of the product is very less, right? Because the manufacturing for them, it might take only 10 rupees or 15 rupees or 20 rupees or less than that. We don't know about it. That's why, because the manufacturing cost is very less, that's why the product cost is very less, right? But in this case, development cost was huge. They spent millions, right? Crores rupees in developing this vaccine, right? So development cost was very high in this case, but the product cost is very less, right? Sometime it will maybe opposite. Development cost will not be that much. Like, say, you are designing a sleeper, you will not be having any hi-fi or DJ, hi-fi development cost. But your product cost will be more, right? Because your product cost will be, say, for 300 rupees. Out of that, 200 is your production cost, and then 100 is your margin. So that means development cost is different than the production cost. So you have to remember that your development cost is also less and your product cost is also less. Sir, to bandh karana to chalu zale sarani chukun chalu gala. Okay, sorry guys. So and then development capabilities. So for that means, while doing the designing, have you gone through any patent or anything, or you have got any experience, so that your whatever research or whatever development or whatever design you did, it is going to help in your future products. Okay, so these are the characteristic of a good, means a good quality. You are giving a good quality product to the customer. As customers are happy with that, it is robust. It is like yesterday only I was seeing. I don't know whether you guys know, but there's something called as a gaming console Wii, right? So today's gaming console we get, within 6 months, this remote control will, they will break. But I got this Wii console in 2007, I think, 7 or 8, 7. Still it is working, my kids play with it, the same remote. It is so robust. So what I'm trying to emphasize here is that your product should be so robust that, it should be usable after long time. Also means it should be the quality should not go down, or it should not break after a long duration. Okay, so this robustness, this is something we talked about, right? It's like a privacy vehicle. If you take any, I don't want to take any brand name, but some car will be, within 3-4 years, it will be, kind of very old. It will look very old, and it will have so much maintenance. But so if you take a, say, 30, 40 years old, by Yamaha RX100, still going on. So that is a robust design, right? So your product should be robust and reliable, right? And Your quality, people should talk about your quality. Obviously, your quality will talk, you know, when people talk about it. Like a good movie, people will talk about it, mouth publicity will make it a hit, right? So your quality should be such that it is, you know, people talk about it. Then cost, as I said, there are two costs, development cost and production cost. So both of them should be as minimum as possible, right? Your if your development cost is less, but your production cost is very high, that is also not. So if you put more time in development, try to reduce the cost of the product so that, you know, customer has to pay less for that. So, and then, as I said, the important thing is the time also. You should deliver your product on time, you know, so that the customers are happy with your product. Like, say, if you are going to a hotel and if your product is your food, right? So if you're taking too much time to deliver that, then customers will not be happy. Okay. So like this, you have to, these are the factors which are the, rather these are the characteristics for a product, you know. Okay. So now let's talk about which are the factors which affect the design and development. Means what are the things, see there, right now we have seen what are these characteristics. These are the things which you have to take care or we have to worry about while we are doing the design and development. Now, which factors affect this design and development? So first is product identification related factor. Means first we need to identify what is the product is required. Like say we need to, you know, develop a hotel, or we need to have a small Xerox center, or we need to have a shoes or pen or fan or car. So what product you want to develop or what product you need to design or come up in the market, that first you need to identify that. So that is going to affect your whole thing. First, gap in demand and supply. Means what? Something, people want something and it is not available in the market. So right now mango is required, right? People, everybody wants mango and they want mango cheap. It is very costly now. So people want mango. So there is a difference of demand and supply. Within 1 month, that difference will come down drastically. That means mango will be available in abundance, and then the costing will go down drastically, right? So that difference of demand and supply, you have to keep it in mind. So like right now, the margin, whatever margin you can find out in mango business, will, it is not available same margin in the next few days. So any, like say AC market, today's AC market is because, you know, this is the time for the purchasing AC. So today's AC market will be much higher compared to summer or winter, right? So we need to see what is the demand or difference between demand should be more than supply, then only you should go in that this thing. Okay. Underutilized resources, right? Then something, some resources are, they are underutilized, means people are not using it as it's, we are supposed to use it. So that also can be part of your product identification. Diversification, limited customer base, means diversification means you should diversify your business. It is not only in one, say, like yesterday and a few days back only I read an article about, so I think one brand, Fortune or something, they started with oil, but now they are everywhere. They have rice and Gehu, all retail product, they have their own brand. So they diversified their business. They did not stuck with one particular business of oil. So you should, you know, for design of diversification, you know, matters for your product identity. Like say, in that case, the example I gave you of, I think Fortune or some other brand was there. Like, or Saffola also. Saffola is now everywhere. If you take, you will get Saffola brand in honey, everything. It started with oil, right? So that means why it is important, because for product design perspective, once we have one product which is people like it, then you can develop another product. So that, you know, people will go for it, you will increase your sale, right? So that factor which affects your product identification, right? So new product ideas, friends, co-workers, and whatever. This is something, you know, which all of you, like, you know, everybody has different fantastic ideas for the business. Okay, this is what we can do. This is what we can do. Okay, so like 100, out of 100 ideas, 10 will be good ideas. Out of that, 2 will be which we can work on. Then 1 will be your final product. So like getting new ideas will be matter, you know, for the product identification. Like idea might be from your friends, from your co-workers, from society, from your some relative, from environment, from some news. You can get ideas from anywhere, right? So like that, this product identification is important So these are the factors, whatever we discuss, these are related to the product. That means we have to identify what product we are going to design. Okay, this is the first factor we talked about. Second factor is marketing related factors. Now, how the marketing is going to go for this product, like prestigious of company, means how much your company is prestigious, like marketing, like Apple product, it is a brand name. Any other phone is not having that kind of brand like Apple. So this will help them in the product design, as well as there are two things. First thing, it will help them in the product design so that their new product will immediately go, people will buy it. But it is also challenging, so they have to maintain that quality so that in designing, they have to worry about it. Say like if Apple goes from 11 to 12 or 12 to 13, they have to come up with something fantastic, something new every time. They cannot say the same phone is with the small changes, this and that, and okay, new. But people will not buy. They have to give, if you see, every version will have something new, some face identification, something which was not there. So you have to keep that in mind while doing the design, that you are giving something new with every new version. Like say, if you are designing a chappal, you cannot give the same chappal with a new version, right? Except software, whatever a software update we get, we cannot give a big update and say, okay, only small things are changed. If there is a huge bug, then giving update is a good idea. Or some new features are available, then giving a new version is a good idea. Like, so marketing is like prestigious of the, how means what is the brand, what is the status of your company in the market. If it is not, then you have to build it. Okay. Then technologically sound product. This we talked about, that your product is technologically sound, means it is very robust. Nobody can challenge it technologically, right? So if your phone is hanging again and again, then people will not buy it, right? Say I still have Apple 1, 2, 3, all those different versions. I have my phone with me and they're working. I am simply not using them because I got a better version and I don't want to use them. But they're still working. I have iPod, which is working. He's not a kid anymore, but kids still play with that. So that is so robust. As I give you the example of Wii, that remote control is still working. So it is technologically sound, so sound that it will be keep working. Like if you take any other example, I had some Micromax phone. Within 6 months, it started giving problems and I have thrown it. I tried any other product, but my point is, technologically your product should be so sound that people will blindly will take your product, that okay, no, it is technological. Like say taking an example of like high brands like Audi or BMW, they are technologically very sound. They have high tech, like Tesla. They're technologically sound and advanced they are. So they don't need to worry about the marketing about those. Okay, customers requirement. Now, while designing, the important thing is whatever customers want, we are giving that to the customer. Okay, customer want one thing and you are giving something and customer say, okay, no, give me my whatever I need first. Okay, your shoes should be, if they have fantastic color and fantastic, bright laces and all that. But if the soles are not proper, it is not proper, they are not comfortable while running, then it is of no use, whatever you are putting on top of it, right? So that customer requirements should be satisfied first. That is important thing. Market potential means how much market you can gain. If you cannot have a product which nobody wants, or very few people want it. Like say, take any software, people do not want it right now, and you are trying to push it on the people. So people will not buy it. Right, it should be, market should be, potential should be there in the market. People should be buying it. That should be the factor. That should be the process of thinking when you are doing a design of the product. Product life, how much a product is going to stay in the market. That means say life cycle is 5 to 6 years. After that, it will obviously go, it will be obsolete, the technology will be much better. Now Apple do not support 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, all these, they support only after I think 7. Like Microsoft do not support XP 2003 and all those, they support only after, I think they even don't support 2007 also. are supported in 2010, because those old version maintenance or supporting those will be very costly after a certain time. So they become obsolete, and they're saying that they will only support the new. So this every product has a life. Like operating system has a life, the software has, everything has a life. We'll talk about that life cycle. But that life is important, because once we know that this product is going to be now obsolete, we have to come up with something better. So that life is an important factor, and competition. Market madliji competition, whatever competition you have in the market, that is very important, because you know, with the competition only you will survive, you will get a good ideas, you will come up with better design, better product, and then you will compete with them, and then you want to, means people will decide which is better, and they will go word with that. Okay, so this is market related factors we talked about. First we talked about product identification factors, then we talked about market factors, then there are legal factors. Legal factors means while during the design, you have to remember, like say, if you say, I want to, you know, in Pune, I would like to have a building of 200 floors. Many people have money, so people, but it is not all those, you know, taking the permissions, environments and all that. Like say, if you go in a village and, you know, on a farm, you cannot have a house of, you know, 10 story building, and because it is you have to take a permission on that. So these are all environment related factors. So for doing a product, developing a product, you have to remember what are the limitations from the government, what are the limitations, what are the law, what is the law says about it, what is the environment pollution thing. Like say if you have a chemical factory and you are throwing the chemicals in the river, it is not allowed. Like what are the import issues? You want something which is not available in India, you want to import it from Germany. So what are the restrictions, whether you can import it or not? Like, you know, what is the costing of that? So, or like say for restrictions on the finance means how much money you can get, or how much money you can, you know, build for your business. So like all these factors are the legal factors which where, you know, you have to keep those in mind while doing the design. Like say if you have a hotel, you cannot keep a kid as your worker. It is not legally, it is not allowed. You might be sued for that. That is a legal factor. You have to keep that in mind while doing the business. Like you should have a license of your business, right? So that is a legal factor. So while doing the design, you have to keep all those legal factors in mind. Okay. Let me see how many people are awake. So only Hiram's video is available. Akshay, Aniket, I want you guys' video, because you guys joined and nobody is listening. I don't know whether you guys are listening. So just make your video on. Let me see how many are there. Nobody is responding. That means people are not there.
No, sir, I'm here.
Okay, Aniket, yes, I can hear you. I don't want your...
I'm also here.
Yeah. Okay, that's fine. I just wanted you guys to be attentive. I'm not blaming anyone. Just I want you guys to be attentive. Okay, so let me see. Okay, you guys are listening. If you don't want, you know, if you are... You know, I'm boring you guys. It's not a problem. You can, you know, get out of the lecture anytime. It's not an issue. So join if you are interested, and I just want you guys to be attentive. You can ask me questions if you have any in chat. Okay. So like as I said, this is a theoretical, there is no numericals and all that. So it is a little bit boring, but I am trying to give you examples, my personal experiences, so that to make it more interesting as much as possible. Okay. So let's try to finish this. We have another 10-15 minutes. Okay, these are legal factors. Then finance related factors. Obviously, this is very important factor. When we are, you know, starting a business or developing a product, designing a product, then that you will need lots of money. You can have your own money for design of a product, or you know, you can partner with someone, or you can go in public, ask for the investment. Like, you know, you can go for public and ask for the stocks. People will invest in. So that, how much money, if you say, if you need 5 lakhs, you can build your own finance. Say if you need 20 lakhs, then you cannot do that. You need a partner for that, private partner. Then if you need, say, 5 crores, then going public is a better option. If you're doing something, you know, where government subsidy is available, then you can go for that also. So depending on how much money you need to worry about, you know, your design will be, you know, dependent on this finance. Like as I said, we took an example of Corona vaccine. So Poonawalas had invested a lot in doing the develop research, creating the vaccine, and there now they are selling it and they are going to get money out of it. But the investment was huge. So depends on your depending on your what is your product, what is your idea, you will have a particular investment requirement, and that will affect your design. So capital investment, it may be manufacturing resources, what kind of plants you need, machinery. Like say, if you are coming up with new car, it needs a huge investment, because each and every the forging, each and every your deck, your sound, your display, your glass, your everything will have a different design, different forging machine, different all those things will matter. It will be huge investment. So if your product fails, all those investment will go away. Like if you take an example of Nano, Tata Nano was a big investment. They needed to do it in very low cost, but it was not a very hit car. So whatever investment they did, they might be at loss. We don't know about it, but they invested a lot in all those machinery, all that, to develop this car, but they could not utilize it, and they might be at loss. So the capital investment is very important. We have to remember all those factors: marketing, finance, legal. But this investment, whatever you are doing, that is very important for your design perspective. Cash generation, as I said, there may be many ways to do it. It may be you may get your fixed deposit, you may get it from shares, going public. You can take a government support, you can take a loan. So there are different things which you can do to get the money. Organization related factors. Now this is a company, means a company as a whole. How big is your company? 2 people, 2 or 20 people, 200 people, 2000 or 2 lakh people. Depending on that, your design and all those factors will affect, right? Skill requirements, workers and manager. Now, say you are doing a design. As I said, corona vaccine, they needed a very high skill of very specialized area, right? So like for a fabrication, you need a welder. Or for a person who is experienced in milling or forging. So like that, your skill requirement will vary depending on your product design, and the skills of your workers and your managers. So managers will need different. Managers' job is to manage people, to manage money, to manage your hardware, your resources. So they will have a different skills. They will not. They might know, don't know about this technical stuff, but they will be different skills. Have different skills to manage people, and workers will have a different skill. So skill requirement, what your company is having, it will affect your design. Availability of the labor. What is the labor availability? Like say in city, you will get labor easily, but if you go in a village or in a rural area, getting specific labor is very difficult, because people are very less population is there. So to get, say, if you want to fix an AC, so you have to go AC expert will be costly there, right? So availability of the labor, availability of the managers, those factors will affect your product design. Salary and wages of the workers, cost implication. Now this is again, if you have a skilled labor in specific area, the salary will be different than the common skilled worker, right? So this salary and wages means everyday money, and salary means monthly. So those will affect your design. So basically these are organized, means what kind of company you have, what kind of skills you have. If you have a specialized skills, then your design will be different. If you don't have, then you have to spend money, you have to get a labor with the specialized skills and do the design. So this your organization, your factors will matter a lot in your design. Then manufacturing related factors. Now, if you are going to do a design, and then you need something very, a specialized manufacturing process. So that time your design will be different, but you say, I need a steel bar of 9.7 mm diameter. So I have to manufacture it, right? Because it is not available in the market. But if I'm using a steel rod of 9, 10, it is easily available in the market. So whether your manufacturing capacity, you are doing something which is out of the ordinary, it is something special, then your costing will go up, your availability will go up. I don't know whether it will be available or not. So availability of the technological, it's like cost, equipments, what is available in the market, whether it is doable or not. Then cost of manufacturing facilities, whether how much it will cost. If you are doing something, you say, I want this, but it is I want a surface, hi-fi surface finish. It has a problem, like it will, cost will increase, it will rust very fast. So all those issues will be there. You have to remember those while doing the manufacturing of your while doing the design. We have to consider these manufacturing factors also. Quality of manufactured product, like now say if we are doing to reduce the cost, you are trying to reduce the manufacturing cost, which is affecting the quality, then again your design is not good, right? So rate of production, market demand, means your production rate should be supporting the market demand. As I said, take example of any phone, iPhone, say any phone. If they are coming with new version, they release it in the market, but at the same time they will have a supply of say 2-3 million, 10 million products will be ready. They are not they will advertise and they will not say, okay, now this will be available after 3 months, 4 months. Then the advertisement will go waste. They will have all those designs, all the products will be ready, say 10 million ready to ship, and then they will advertise. That means people will keep asking and they will be immediately supplying it. So that rate of production should match with the market demand. That is very important. You have to keep that in mind, right? That your rate of production is matching. And you cannot say that demand is there, but I cannot supply it because, you know, it's in the production. No, you have to keep, take an idea what is will be the demand, and accordingly you have to work on the production. Now, distribution related factors. This is another factor. Like once you develop the product, or once you design the product, once you manufacture the product, how the distribution will be there. Like say, take an example of say any car service center, say Maruti service center. The distribution of the Maruti is important, because you know it should be easily available to people. People don't need to go to other city to get. Like say, if you are, I want to buy a Rolls Royce. It's not available in Pune. I don't know whether it is available or not. It will be available in very specific area, because it is very specific car. It is very it is only for many very specific population. So availability of the distributor is very important. You should be easily available. Like take an example of say any food product, like say Balaji wafers. It should be distributors should be able to distribute it in each and every corner of your city or corner of your state, so that it is available to the customer. Your reputation, your facilities for the distribution, your manpower for the distribution. So distribution network should be awesome. Like say right now, important things are, you know, this online distributors are there. So they help you a lot. Like say, we take example of mangoes. Mangoes is online, it is available. Amazon is a good channel. Like say, for food delivery, there is Swiggy and Zomato. You don't need to worry about the distribution, because you have to just manufacture and they will do the distribution of your product. So like that, distribution is important factor while doing the designing. Like warehouses, whether warehouses is big enough, they have enough space, they have special facilities like light, water, and it is not very costly. Because if you want to get a warehouse in Pune, it will be very costly. If you go a little bit outside, then it will be much cheaper. You can store your product there. So that is important factor while doing the design. After sale service, as I said, like maintenance, repairing, spares cost. So like costing or maintenance of said duster is very high, but for Maruti it is not. So people will just because of the maintenance, some people will say, okay, I will not get X brand, I will not get Y brand. My maintenance is less for this brand, so I will take that brand. So it is same, true for any product. Like if the maintenance is very high, people will, mouth publicity will be there that maintenance is very high. So like say for high-end cars, maintenance is very high. So your maintenance, your repairs, it should be, it should be easily doable and people should be able to fix that. Sales personnel, like people who are selling your product, what kind of people are there, how they can sell it. So all those things will matter in your product design. So these are, I think, these are the factors I had listed. So there is something called product life cycle. We'll talk about it in next lecture. But there are many factors while you are doing design and development. You need to worry about starting with the concept, then how your product will be manufactured, how your product will be conceptualized, how it will be, prototype will be developed, how it will be manufactured, what kind of manufacturing processes will be there, how much cost, how we can reduce the cost while doing the manufacturing by using a less costly manufacturing process, then how we can improve the quality, how we can what kind of market demand is there, what kind of market what is the gap between demand supply, what kind of public or what class of public is going to take it, then how the distribution will happen, how people will get it, how the sales service will happen, how after sale service, how the product will be retired, how what is the life cycle, what is the life of a product, like say 1 year, 10 year, so after retirement what can we offer in the new, all those things we have to keep in mind while doing the design. And while doing the for going for the next iteration of the design, all those things will again come into picture, and it's a loop and loop and loop. At the end of the product life cycle, you will come up with new ideas, new product design, and again it will go through all those product cycles of the product life cycle. Okay, so these are the factors we talked about today. What are different factors? So I categorize them in different areas, and there we talked about it. But these factors which we will keep in mind all the time while doing the design. Okay. So I don't think there is a good idea to start a new topic because we have exactly 1 minute left. So let's close this lecture here. Yesterday we talked about product, what is product design, and then what is a good design. Today we started with what are the characteristics of a good design, means what we can say a good design. And then we talked about factors, many factors which affects your product design. Tomorrow we'll talk about this a little bit about product life cycle. And then some new technologies in the product design. Okay. Any doubt you guys have? I have taken a screenshot of the attendance. You guys, any doubt is there? You can ask me in the chat. We have less than half minute. So if there is no doubt, I will assume that you guys are okay. And then we will close this session. So in the next few seconds, you can ask me if you have any doubt. Otherwise, this lecture will be automatically, I think, it will close. Thank you, guys. You can ask me any questions you have in WhatsApp also. Okay. Thank you, guys. Thank you, Akshay.